It's my job to watch game film all day and all night, come up with observations and conclusions, and then present them every week to all of you on this channel. It's by far the best job I've ever had, and I would like to think that I get my conclusions right more often than not. But, as with all things when you're giving opinions on literally hundreds of different subjects over a multi-year period, you're going to get some things wrong. And believe me, I have gotten some things very, very wrong. However, there are those special cases, those select few topics where I get things so unbelievably, unequivocally wrong that I need to dedicate an entire episode talking about how wrong I really was. That's what we're doing here today with Patrick Mahomes. To say that he has exceeded my expectations is an impossibly large understatement. And to be honest, he's probably even exceeding the expectations of even some of the most rabid Mahomes supporters in the Chiefs kingdom as well. I mean, 13 touchdowns in 3 weeks. That's never been done before. Mahomes is on pace to shatter, well, pick a record, any record, really. It's hard to temper my reactions to this kind of production because we have literally never seen this kind of production happen in history. And you could say, oh, well, the only reason that Mahomes is finding success is because of Andy Reid's system. And yes, to a degree, that is true. Mahomes is benefiting from the same clever play design that Alex Smith did that was notorious for, as some would say, artificially manufacturing touchdown passes. But Mahomes' success, and my newfound belief in him, goes way beyond cute play calls and giving all the credit to his receivers. There are a lot of things that Mahomes does both before and after the snap that I never thought he would be doing this early coming out of Texas Tech, and I'll give an example of that. This was one of my favorite throws of his so far this year, and it's from the first quarter in that Week 2 game against the Steelers. And I want to point out something about the defense here, because what Pittsburgh is doing on this snap is really interesting. Based on the alignment of the corners and of the safeties, this looks like the Steelers are in man coverage. You've got all the corners on one side with all the receivers, and you've got a safety over on the other side with the tight end. Usually, if this is a zone coverage, you're not going to have all the corners on one side and all the safeties on the other, so this is a big red flag for man coverage. Now, before the Chiefs do any of their typical pre-snap motion that they always do, Patrick Mahomes comes up and slides the protection to the left. After calling out the protection, he then motions Tyreek Hill to the right and the cornerback, Cameron Sutton, follows him. During that motion, as Mahomes is reading all these signals for man, he flips Kareem Hunt from his left to his right to run the flare route. And then on the broadcast angle, you can hear him simultaneously shouting, "Get set, get set, get set," to Tyreek Hill. So, what does all of that mean together, and why is that important to the reevaluation of Mahomes that we're doing here? When Mahomes reads that this is likely a man defense, he is now thinking about the possibility of the Steelers bringing extra pressure while all these receivers are manned up. So when he slides the protection left, that's his way of accounting for a potential blitz either from this weak side inside linebacker, or maybe if they're running some sort of zone pressure from the slot, that protection slide can also pick up a potential corner blitz from that direction. Meanwhile, flipping Hunt's route means that if this Mike linebacker Vince Williams is blitzing, he has Hunt on that side as a quick hot read to get him out of trouble, because remember, he will not have enough bodies to protect against that on that side. So if pressure comes left, he's got protection, and if pressure comes right, he's got a hot throw available to him. And as he's flipping Hunt, he is shouting, "Get set, get set, get set," because he thinks he's got all the answers to this defense that he needs, and he wants to snap this ball before the Steelers get spooked and change their look. Now, here's where it gets really interesting, because Mahomes does not have all the answers, and the Steelers defense has been playing him this whole time. It's not a single high safety man coverage. They drop out of it and play a Tampa 2 zone, and what's sneaky about it is that they flip the responsibility of the corner Cameron Sutton and the safety Morgan Burnett to disguise this coverage. They've got Burnett playing as the flat zone defender while Sutton is dropping as the deep half field defender, which is the opposite of how this coverage is usually executed between the corner and the safety. It's really tricky because they're trying to confuse and fluster Mahomes by turning all of that pre-snap motion that the Chiefs are known for against him. And if Mahomes cannot trust the looks that he's getting pre-snap when he's reading all the motions and the alignment, then the Steelers think that they can get him to slow down when processing everything. And the slower he's processing coverages, the easier it will be for them to either bait him into bad throws or get him with pressure. But Mahomes does not slow down at all when reading this role in the coverage post-snap, and that's the part that probably surprised me the most. As soon as he read these linebackers were dropping into a zone and that they had help over the top, he threw a dart without hesitation right to the spot he needed to, both in order to protect Kelce from contact and to give him a chance to score. If this was man coverage with no safety help over the top, he would have carried this ball a little bit further upfield, put a bit more touch on it, and elevated its placement so that it would essentially turn into a jump ball in the back of the end zone, which Kelce is going to win a majority of the time. However, since there was now a zone defender helping over the top and another zone defender helping inside, Mahomes does not have the luxury of throwing a jump ball anymore. He needs to put as much gas on this thing as possible and hit this window in front of the goal line immediately before this safety and linebacker can get in position and sandwich Kelce in the end zone. This was Mahomes' only window for a clean throw that he was going to get against this roll in coverage, and he both recognized it quickly and threw it perfectly to hit that window. If you had told me a year ago that Mahomes was going to be doing all of this in his third career start, changing protections, adjusting routes to give him a viable hot throw if he needed it, making a good pre-snap read and then making an even better post-snap read, and most importantly throwing the right kind of ball into the right kind of coverage, well, I just flat out would have not believed you on any of that. And yet here we are. There was another touchdown later in that same game, and I swear it looks like he was just playing Madden out on the field. It was so easy for him. Mahomes recognizes that the Steelers are giving him a two-deep coverage because Terrell Edmonds is not so subtly hanging out over the top and inside of Tyreek Hill, who is isolated on the left-hand side. And he's aligned that way because they want to obviously bracket him for most of this game and try to limit the damage he can cause. After seeing that pre-snap look, Mahomes changes the formation to empty and the play to a divide concept with Travis Kelce. And a divide concept is great against a two deep zone look because it gives Kelce, who's one of the most dangerous weapons in the NFL at any position, a chance to use his size and speed to his advantage by splitting these safeties deep in the middle seam. However, he isn't just going to magically be open just because this play call is a good one against this defense. Pat Mahomes still needs to help him out a little bit, and he does that from the pocket by looking far to his left at Tyreek Hill on the boundary, acting like he's looking for a deep ball one-on-one, and that widens this deep half safety out towards Hill. The wider that safety gets while following Mahomes' eyes, the wider that seam will get for Travis Kelce. So when Mahomes comes back to Kelce over the middle, there's nobody within 5 yards of him, and it's one of the easiest touchdowns they'll get all year. Again, Mahomes is recognizing defenses, changing plays, moving defenders with his eyes after the snap, and showing off his incredible arm talent to get the ball in the hands of his best playmakers. This is everything you want to see from a quarterback and more. When Aaron Rodgers does this, we don't bat an eye. When Carson Wentz or Matthew Stafford or Russell Wilson do this, we just expect it at this point. Well, when Pat Mahomes is doing this from now on, we shouldn't be surprised anymore either. Or at the very least, I shouldn't be. You want to know why the Chiefs' offense is so damn hard to game plan against? Because you have basically no reliable calls to turn to in coverage. If you go man across the board, their top four weapons, Hill, Kelce, Hunt, and Watkins, will roast you alive. If you go zone, Mahomes can move your safeties and linebackers wherever he wants to with his eyes, and then roast you again. What exactly are you supposed to do against this, other than just build an incredible defensive line rotation and sack him before he can get the ball out? That's basically the only card the defenses have left to play, assuming they can even hit him without drawing a 15-yard penalty, which is a whole different can of worms that I'm really not going to open up this week. And even then, let's say you do get a good rush going and you move Mahomes off of his spot. When he has the athleticism to scramble around and buy time, and the arm to still throw a dime off his back foot across his body to find a receiver in the back of the end zone, what the hell are you supposed to do about that? There's nothing you can do, and I'm starting to think that when Mahomes is on, like really on, just like what we always say with Aaron Rodgers, no matter what you do on defense, you will be wrong. I mean, I'll admit that I gave the Chiefs a lot of crap for taking Pat Mahomes in the top 10. But good God, I don't think anybody could have seen this coming, even Chiefs fans at the time. They may have hoped for it and wished for it, yes, but I doubt that very many of them expected it and predicted it. And for everyone who's still on the skeptic train like I used to be, you can try to point to stats and say, oh, well, touch passes on the goal line really shouldn't count, or that he shouldn't get credit for touchdowns where his receivers break a bunch of tackles and do most of the work for him. But I personally think that we're way past that point already. We're no longer in the skepticism and doubt stage of this. Pat Mahomes is doing things on the field that I genuinely think that maybe at most four other quarterbacks in the league are capable of doing. Maybe. Will he continue this pace all season and finish with 70 passing touchdowns? No, probably not. He will slow down and he will eventually start to throw some interceptions. That's just how the NFL works. But when he does throw those interceptions, or he does lose a game, or he does have an above average day rather than a ridiculous record-breaking day, remember this video. Remember the expectations he has already surpassed, and remember that you're allowed to be wrong, just like he's allowed to have an off day. I think the success of Pat Mahomes, along with the early success of the Browns and the Dolphins and the Buccaneers, is exactly what NFL fans needed right now, myself included. The majority needed to be wrong for once, and the minority needed to be right. That's what keeps the league exciting. That's what makes the NFL so fun to watch. We need bad teams to become good in just the span of one half. We need teams that nobody believes in to conjure up a bit of magic and win crazy games, or in some cases, conjure up Fitz magic. The NFL is better when expectations are shattered, and it's better when some young new superstar rises above the rest of the sport, even if only for a moment. I'm excited to see where Pat Mahomes goes from here, and I'm excited to see if he can finally be the one to deliver this team some actual playoff success. But most of all, as weird as it sounds, I'm excited to see him continue to prove me wrong over and over and over again. Thank you so much for watching today's episode. It's a very rare time indeed when we get multiple Film Room episodes in the same week. But as you all know, I'm going to be out of the country next week, so I won't have any new episodes coming out during that time. So I wanted to give you guys a bonus show this week to kind of offset that. And you can also thank our sponsor, MyBookie, for this extra episode, by the way, because they are the ones paying me to abandon my sleep cycle and give it to you. So thank you to MyBookie for motivating me, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, to release this. And if you'd also like to show your gratitude to MyBookie, they have an excellent deal going on for all Film Room viewers right now. Just enter promo code Brett on signup, and you can get a 100% signup bonus of up to $1,000 on your initial deposit, or any deposit below that, of course. You can bet on anything from the NFL to college football to basketball, baseball, combat sports, esports, racing, I mean, friggin' politics. They've got anything you could possibly want to bet on. So if you want to lay down some money on, say, the Chiefs to beat the Broncos in Denver this week, I think they're 5-point favorites, even though it's on the road, so it's a pretty crazy line. Or conversely, if you think the Broncos are finally going to be the team that slows down Pat Mahomes, just head to the link in the description below, enter promo code Brett on signup, deposit whatever you want to deposit to get your bonus, and then start betting. As for me, I'll be back in about 2 weeks with another Film Room episode. I have no idea on what yet, of course, because a lot can change in 2 weeks. But in the meantime, you can also support the channel on my Patreon page, where I've got weekly picks exclusive for all patrons, as well as a monthly patron-only Q&A where you can ask me literally anything you want. So check that out as well. I'll be back soon, and until then, later.